It's time for some good news from the world of science. Swedish company Minesto has developed a technology for generating electricity that is said to be significantly cheaper than most other types of power plants. It is a kite that produces electricity underwater with the help of ocean and tidal currents. In fact, it is already in use. On the Faroe Islands, such a tidal kite with an output of 1.2 megawatts is in operation. According to the company, an output of 600 gigawatts could be achieved worldwide with the kite. That is almost twice as much as the output of all nuclear power plants worldwide combined. In this video, we are talking about how the tidal kite works, what hurdles the technology could still face, and how much it can contribute to the energy generation of the future. And with that, I say welcome to the German Science Guy. My name is Jacob, and in Germany we say los geht's. The seas and oceans can be used to generate an extremely large amount of energy. Various sources can be used for this, for example currents or tides, and even the salinity. In fact, more than twice the world's current energy consumption could be covered in this way. According to estimates, between 45,000 and 130,000 terawatt hour of electricity per year could be generated from the sea. By comparison, around 25,300 terawatt hours of electricity was consumed worldwide in 2021. However, we are still a long way from producing this much electricity with the help of the ocean. So far, just 535 megawatts of power has been installed. This corresponds to a maximum annual energy production of 4.7 terawatt hours. This is just 0.004% of the maximum potential of the oceans. But this seems to be changing. A number of projects for such technologies are in the starting blocks. If they are all implemented in the future, the total output would increase to 3 gigawatts, so around 26.3 terawatt hour of electricity per year. Although this is still a long way from the possible potential, it is already many times more than before. Most of the projects are tidal stream and wave power plants. One such tidal power plant is the Minesto kite. The company emerged from the aerospace company Saab in 2007 and could perhaps bring about a small revolution in the field of renewable energies. But before we get to what the company promises, let's take a look at how the tidal kite works. First, let's take a look at the structure of the kite. Visually, it looks a bit like the kites we know from the beach. However, there's a turbine on the wings. This is directly connected to a generator, which can then be used to produce electricity. There are also rudders attached to the back of the wings to steer the kite in the right direction. It is controlled by an autonomous control system that steers the kite along an H-shaped path. A rope of bracket containing cables is attached under the kite. These are for the power supply or communication, for example. The electricity produced also reaches land through these cables. This bracket is then connected to the foundation and can be locked and unlocked relatively easily, for example for installation or to haul in the rope. Cameras can then be used to attach the cable without the need for a diver or diving robot to descend. According to the company, the foundation has been developed in such a way that material such as concrete and therefore CO2 can be safe in contrast to conventional foundations. A steel cylinder is drilled into the seabed. This is then fixed in place with concrete under high pressure. In fact, the first installation actually took just 24 hours. This is amazingly fast. The size of the kite can vary depending on the energy requirements. The wingspan is between 4.9 and 12 meters and the weight between 2.7 and 28 tons. This should then be able to produce between 100 kilowatts and 1.2 megawatts of energy. Quite a range in financial terms, but also in terms of size. But let's take a look at how this is supposed to work. In principle, the technology is not only visually similar to the kites on the beach, but also in terms of function, only in the water. It is installed at a depth of around 50 meters. In order to produce electricity, it needs average peak current speeds of 1.5 meters per second. That's quite a lot, at least in relation to the North Sea. The tidal currents in there have a speed of between a few centimeters and just under 70 centimeters. In other words, significantly lower. In other places, however, the speed can be significantly higher. For example, in Alderney Race north of France, maximum speeds of 5 meters per second are said to be achieved there. This could therefore be more lucrative. The so-called hydrodynamic lift is responsible for the movement of the kite. You may be familiar with dynamic lift from airplanes. This is the reason why airplanes and kites fly. The air flows around the wings of the airplane. If the wings are now tilted slightly, the air particles bounce against them at the bottom. This causes the air to accumulate there. This increases the pressure under the wing. Above the wing, however, it decreases. The pressure difference then creates a force upwards perpendicular to the wing. This pressure difference is also caused by the Bernoulli effect. This occurs when the wings are curved at the top. The airflow has to travel a longer distance at the top than below the wing. As a result, the air is faster at the top and the pressure above the wing is lower than below the wing. This is why the upward force is generated again. This is a lift that ensures that the airplane or kite flies. The Tidal Kite works in exactly the same way. The difference is that water flows around the wings instead of air. The Tidal Kite is aligned at a slight angle to the current. It is also steered along the H-shaped path by the control system. It can therefore reach speeds that are greater than the flow velocities. According to the company, this works like a kite. This angled position splits the aerodynamic force into two components. On the one hand, continued lift, and the other, an additional force in the direction of the wind or water. This is actually the reason why such a kite is used and not simply a turbine in the current. The turbine on the kite moves at the same speed as a kite. The water that flows through it is therefore also faster than the current. And this means that more electricity can be produced than if the water flows through it at the speed of the current. The turbine can then be built much smaller. Nevertheless, just as much electricity is generated. This makes it cheaper to operate, install, and maintain. The kite has been in use since 2019. The manufacturer, Minesto, now even has a contract with the electricity provider on the Faroe Islands. The first power plant was put into operation there in 2022. And at the beginning of February this year, an even larger power plant with an output of 1.2 megawatt was installed and tested. It is located at a depth of 50 meters. It moves along a 70 meter H-shaped tract. According to the company, the alignment with the current has worked well so far. It has also produced as much electricity as predicted. So far, it actually seems to be quite successful. Minesto even wants to increase the total output in the waters of the Faroe Island. A total of 7 power plants are to be built. Together, they will have a capacity of 200 megawatts. At 400 million euros, this is quite an investment with the aim of making the Faroe Island emission-free by 2030. This could even be just the beginning. According to the company, an output of 600 gigawatt could be installed worldwide. That is with Minesto's power plants alone. By way of comparison, the combined output of all nuclear power plants is around 371 gigawatt, which is slightly more than half. If the figures are correct, that would be pretty impressive and a huge success for renewable energies. The Tidal Kite is also said to have other advantages. The biggest is probably that electricity production can be predicted fairly well. Ocean and tidal currents are relatively easy to predict. This is more difficult with wind or photovoltaics. The Tidal Kite could therefore be used to provide relatively reliable baseload electricity. According to the company, the capacity utilization of the power plant should be also quite high. It should be between 70 and 95%. And one of the advantages is that there's plenty of space in the water and few problems, for example, because of neighboring residential areas, which is a problem when it comes to wind power. At least it is in Germany. The most important question now, of course, is how much will the electricity cost? Let's take a closer look at the so-called levelized cost of energy. The abbreviation for this LCOE, which stands for levelized cost of energy. LCOE is a cost that is incurred when a form of energy is converted into electricity. This makes it relatively easy to compare the price of the electricity produced. For example, site conditions, acquisition costs, and operating costs are taken into account. The electricity generation costs also depend on the total installed capacity. According to the company, they should be around 100 euros per megawatt hour for the kite. The prerequisite is a total installed capacity of 100 megawatt. If the power plant is located in strong currents, they could even be as low as 50 euros per megawatt hour. This puts Minesto well below the target set by the European Commission, which wants the LCOE for tidal energy to be 150 euro per megawatt hour by 2025. By 2030, they should fall to 100 euro per megawatt hour. So if the company's figures are correct, that would be a real breakthrough. As a disclaimer, I have to say that the figures are from 2017. But let's compare the figures with other types of power plants. According to a study by the Fraunhofer Institute, electricity generation with onshore wind turbines and photovoltaics is the cheapest. In 2021, the LCOE for onshore wind power plants was between 39.4 euros and 82.9 euros per megawatt hour. Depending on the strength of the currents, the tidal kite could therefore come very close to the value. Compared to offshore wind power, it would perform even better, with LCOE of between 72.3 euros and 121.3 euros per megawatt hour. However, the output of offshore turbines is significantly higher. By 2025, their average output in Germany is expected to be around 11 megawatts per turbine. That is almost 10 times the output of a tidal kite, but this could perhaps increase. In addition, the low costs in combination with the other advantages makes it an interesting alternative for the time being. In fact, Minesto is not the only company that relies on tidal energy. In fact, there's quite a lot of competition, some of which I have already reported on my German channel. If you want an English version of these videos, please write it in the comments. The current projects have a total capacity of 2.4 gigawatts, if they are all implemented. By comparison, there are currently around 10.6 megawatt installed, which is 1/226 of that. A total of 40 tidal power plant projects are underway in 15 countries. It has to be said that not all projects will probably be implemented. Nevertheless, what is happening in this area is quite striking. But although this technology already seems to have a lot of potential, there are still some challenges. Of course, we want to take a look at these, but first subscribe to the channel and activate the bell so you don't miss a single video. And that brings us to the part of the video where we have a critical look on the problems. And in Germany, we say it's a große Aber, which would be translated to the big but this is problematic in English. So I ask you, what should I call it? And I think there are some good ideas from the community. So what do you think? Is it better to call it the critical obstacle or the key hurdle? Just write it in the comments, and in the future, I will always use this wording. So, let's come for one more time to the große Aber. Today, this is made up of two points. The first point is the wear and tear. The tidal kite is permanently exposed to relatively strong ocean currents. This could or will have an effect on the material. You can see this in pretty much everything we put in the sea. I also asked the company for information about this, but unfortunately, I didn't get an answer. What we can say, however, is that offshore foundations have a service life of up to 50 years, which is not bad, but such foundations are probably difficult to compare with a kite, so it remains to be seen whether wear and tear is really a problem. The second point of criticism is probably also the bigger one. It's about the ecological consequences of the tidal kite. Minesto advertises that it is very environmentally friendly, but I couldn't find any information about how loud this kite is supposed to be, for example. This is a frequently mentioned problem with offshore wind turbines. The loud noises of the wind turbines are extremely stressful for marine life. A major problem in this context is the construction of the foundation, for example. Pile driving into the ground is extremely loud, and with Minesto's technology, this takes 24 hours. But there are also methods to reduce the noise level. It remains to be seen whether Minesto will implement such protection methods. Nevertheless, I find the technology very exciting. I believe that it can make a very important and major contribution to renewable energies through this baseload. And the technology also shows how much is happening in the energy sector and in technology in general. It certainly gives us great hope for the future. But what do you think about this technology? Write it in the comments and subscribe to the channel. And here's another video of mine, so go watch it now. And I say goodbye oder auf Wiedersehen. Macht's gut, euer Jakob.